Hi students, welcome back. I am Umesh Bhamre. Today we'll go to geography lesson number 1.
Lesson number 1, geography, field visit. Do you know students what is field visit? Field visit means where we visit for certain reasons. We visit different places, right? For different purposes. We visit malls, we visit museums, we visit government offices. So there are different reasons, different purpose to visit different places. So lesson number 1 tells you about field visit. So what do we have to do after a field visit? A report is written, right? We have to write a report on the basis of information obtained during the field visit. We collect different information after visiting a place. So whatever we write after visiting that place, we call it as a report. And the report is very important during field visit. Exactly what did you visit? Where did you visit? Why did you visit? What was the purpose behind it? There are many questions. We'll see the questionnaire later on. But report writing is one of the important information which you can obtain during the field visit. What things do you have to carry during field visit? The things you have to carry are notebook, questionnaire. You have to prepare a proper questionnaire. What questions are you going to ask to the particular, at the particular place or to the respective person? So you have to carry a notebook, a pen to jot down some important points. You have to also can carry a pencil or a scale or a tape to measure the things. It depends on different places what things you can carry. You also can carry a compass. Yes, compass which shows you the direction. If you are going in the field, right? Outside the city, outside the village. If you are going in the forest or in the open at some different places, compass will show you the directions. Then you can also carry a bag for collecting samples. Why do we need a bag? So that we can collect some important things which you have not seen before or which are different in that place, on which you have to study further. So you can carry that samples. For example, different types of rocks you can carry, different types of plants, leaves, seeds, right? Whatever you find different from your place, you can carry that, you can collect that in your bags. So you have to carry a bag also, a map also of that particular place, how to go, where to go, that map will guide you. You also have to carry a camera so that you can click some important photographs which will help you in preparing a report. What things do we have to study there during a geographical visit or during a field visit? First thing is physical landforms. You know, physical landforms are very important. Physical landform means what? Exactly how is the land there? Is it plain? Is it a plateau region? Are there valleys, mountains, right? Sea coast? Exactly how is the land? How is the landform? What type of soil is there? Then what type of climates are there? If it is a river bank, how much area does that river occupy? How is the river basin? From where does the river get water? There are so many questions you can study about a particular place. If it is a dam, if you are visiting a dam, you can also prepare questions that where does this dam get water from? How is the water distributed? What is the water used for? Whether agriculture or whether different purposes. If you are visiting a coastal area, again your questionnaire changes. What type of climate? What type of people live there? What is their main occupation? So many questions can come there. Because when you visit places, you find something different there than your place, than the place where you live. So you can prepare a lot of questions, lot of things which you can study there, which you can prepare a report there. If you are visiting a tourism site, for example, forts or palaces or museums or offices, again your questionnaire will change, right? And even if you are collecting about geographical elements there. Geographical elements means what? Are you going to study their soil or climate or population or customs, right? How is the land there? So many things you can study. Villages, if you are visiting villages, you can write about how is the lifestyle of the people, what are their occupations, what type of food they do they eat, language, right, clothing, many things. Forest areas, if you are visiting a forest area, you can also ask some questions to the tribal people, or you can visit that forest and see what type of crops or trees are grown there, what type of animals are mostly seen in that region. Next is, after field visit, the most important thing is what things you can carry there. There are some other important things also which you need to carry. For example, cap, rope, torch, which will help you in different places. You need a cap to protect your head from harsh sunlight, right, or rain. You also need a rope if you are crossing a tough region, rough region. You need to carry a rope. You need to carry a torch also, which will help you in different situations. If you are going early in the morning or late in the evening, you need a torch. You need a compass to show directions. You need a binoculars to watch far away things, right? So that you will easily come to know what regions you are going to. You need to carry a water bottle so that you can drink water time to time. You can, right? You also need to carry chocolates. If it is a rough and tough region, you also need to carry chocolates, because chocolates will give you a lot of energy. This is an actual field visit where you can see students are visiting that agriculture region. The teacher is guiding them, how they are going in a queue, in a line, how they are in a disciplined manner. They are going there and they study about different agriculture products there, how the soil is there. Even the local people are helping them. They are also studying about the local people there. Okay. The preparations, what preparations can you do before going to a field visit? You have to select an appropriate place. Right? The place is very important. The place which you select should be convenient for all. Right? Close to your region, where you can find easily accessible regions, right, which should not be too much risky for all the people. So you should create an appropriate place. Another thing, you know, you should also study that, is that place important for us to study? Is it related with our studies? That also you have to take into consideration. Next thing, topic to study. What topic you are going to study there. So before that, you have to decide a timetable. You have to prepare a proper timetable there. Without timetable, you cannot do anything. Without planning, you cannot do anything. Another important thing is climate. The most important thing is climate. The climate there. How is the climate there? The region where you are visiting, is the climate harsh, rainy, sunny, right? Cold. You have to study about the climate also. So these are the preparations to do when you are going to visit a place. Even you need to take the permissions of the authorities. Permission of the authorities means what? Permission of your school, of your parents, of the people, or of the head of the person where you are visiting. So if you are visiting a factory, you need to take a permission of the factory owner, the manager of the factory, so that there should be no disturbance in their work. Right, so permission of the authorities is very important before visiting a field study. You also have to see about travel arrangements. How are you going there? What type of travel arrangements are you taking? Or how will you go there? Whether you are taking a school bus, whether you are taking a private bus, everything. How much will it cost? Everything, and how many students are going? So that share can be, or that money can be equally divided. So travel arrangements are also very important for you. Next, I told you already, expense, traveling expense, staying expense, food, all this expense has to be calculated and then divided among the students. The information, wherever you are going, you should have proper information about that place. you should know the time of departure there. When to go, when are you going, when are you coming, at what time will you reach there, right? How much time will you require to travel? All these things are very necessary, dear students. Then the next important thing is essential things to carry. You should not carry too heavy or a lot of things in the bag. You should carry light. Yeah, lightweight and important things only, which are important for you to carry at that place. I told you, things will differ according to the place which you visit. You also have to prepare a questionnaire in hand beforehand. Before visiting that place, your questionnaire should be ready. I'll show you how a questionnaire should be prepared. I have already prepared a sample of questionnaire, so we'll go through that only. Right now, questionnaire means what exactly? What place are you visiting? The most important thing is, you know, dear students, a field visit is nothing but a planning. Planning of whom? A teamwork. We should be together, a group, a team. All the management should be done, and if everything is done properly, it becomes effective, right? If you want to make your field study effective, plan it properly. What precautions do we have to do during field visit? The most important thing is you have to be safe. Safety matters a lot, right? Safety is the most important thing you have to do during field visit. You also, if you are visiting a coastal area, you have to be very cautious about the tides there. How is the tide, high tides or low tides, and how is that place there? You know, you have to be very cautious, very careful about the high tide and low tide, and also the place where you are visiting. Is that place easy to go, easy to come, right? So everything you have to be clear about before visiting the place. Also, a list of instructions has to be prepared, which everybody has to follow it. The instructions should be prepared by the leader, by the school head, by the person who is already accessible to that region or who already knows that region. So all the list of instructions, rules should be prepared. And dear students, we should follow the instructions because the place is new to us, right? Next, the way of our behavior there, the language which we are using for conversation there, it very useful. It should not be rough. We should always be polite with the people there where you are visiting, right? If you cooperate them, or they will also cooperate you. Next thing is care of environment. Dear students, care of environment is also very necessary. When you are visiting a particular place, it is very important to take care of the environment there. You should not harm the trees, animals, or the environment there. You should also take care of the environment. Not go there and damage that places. Like some people go and damage the places like forts and trees and all this. So you should also take care of the environment. Next thing is you should also always carry a first aid box. First aid box is very important for you. Why first aid box is important? So that in emergency, for safety, it should be there with you. If anybody by mistake, or it should not happen, but if anybody gets hurt, or so first aid box is always necessary. Next thing is the places which you visit should not be remote places, means which should not be too far away from your place. It should be easily accessible, where you can easily go, easily come back, where the vehicle can reach. So you should select such a place which will be close or easily accessible to you. Next is another thing, the most important thing is you should have the emergency contact numbers of your school heads, of your parents, of the place where you are visiting, and you should exchange them with each other so that the parents, teachers and the people will be contact with, they will have an emergency contact, right, with each other. So these are some of the important things. Now field report, right? Field report, what should your field report include? The most important thing is introduction. Your field report should include a introduction, that who visited, when did you visit, right, how many students, introduction of just 2-3 lines. Next is location, which place was it, where was it, how did you go, how was the route, right, which places did you visit in between. You know, all that location map is very important. Next is physiography of that region. I told you physiography means landforms. How was that region? Was it on a plateau or plains or mountains or valleys? Everything. Then natural factors. How were the natural factors of that region? Is it more rainy region or harsh region or summer harsh climate there? All natural factors you have to include there. Then human settlements. Are you visiting a city or a village? Right? How was the population there? Is it dense or sparse? Right? Means more or less. What type of crops are grown there? Are they seasonal crops or crops are, what type of again crops are grown there? Are they two seasons or the crops are grown for the whole year? And which crops are grown? So if the crops again depends on the rainfall, the soil, the climate there. Then if you are visiting a historical place, again your questions, again your things which you are including in field report will change. What if you are visiting a fort, right from the point it will start that who built it, how did they build it, which were the kings there, who lived there, everything comes. Next is climate, flora and fauna, occupations, climate of that particular region. How is the climate of that region? Is it heavy rainfall or harsh rainfall, whatever it is, or harsh type of climate, or no rain during summers or no water during summers. So you have to study about that region in all these particular things. Flora and fauna means how are the crops there, animals there in that region, what type of crops do you find, flowers do you find, vegetables do you find in that region, which type of animals live there, what occupations people do there. If you are visiting a village, what is their main occupation? What is their allied or subsidiary occupation? These things include that. Population, I already told you, population also you have to take into consideration. Is it harsh? Is it sparse populated or densely populated? Sparse means what? Less. Dense means what? More. Next thing, environmental problems and measures of that place. What type of environmental problems does that region face? Sometimes, you know, some regions where we visit do not have drinking water also in summer season. So these are some of the environmental problems. Or some regions have very heavy rainfall. And what are the measures taken there by the local people, by the local government, by the state government, or by the authorities? What type of measures are taken so that people can be used to that region, or people can be made available with all the things. Then land utilization is another problem. Land utilization means what? What is the land used for? Whether it is used for agriculture or some other occupation, that also your field report should include. And your field report should end with a conclusion. Conclusion is also very important, right? That means what did you learn from that field visit? You also have to, if you are writing a field visit, your field visit should include photographs, diagrams, wherever necessary. Photographs means the place where you visit, right? How did you visit? Now, if you see properly, the proper planning is very important. If you have a proper planning and if you gather some information about that place where you are visiting, it always works. It's a teamwork, and you should always be with the leader or the person who already knows that place. This is a picture of actual field visit. The students have visited the farm, right? The school students, you can see here, they are also working with the farmer. This is a transplantation method, you know, rice cultivation is done here, right? And the students are also actually working and know, becoming one with the nature. They come to know different things. How do they work? How is the transplantation done? Everything they come to know. Here is a sample questionnaire for a factory visit. Suppose if you visit a factory, what type of questions will you prepare? For example, when was the factory established? Right? Which products are manufactured here? Either raw materials are manufactured or finished products are manufactured, or is this a factory supplier of any other industry? So you also have to collect all this information. If this factory is of finished products, where do they get raw material from? This is also one of the important question. What type of raw material do they require? Then who provides essential factors to the factory? For example, water, road, electricity, right? There are many things which are important factors, essential factors for a factory or industry. So how do they get this all these things from, or where do they get all these things from? How far is the market from the factory? If they are producing finished products, how do they sell their goods? Where do they sell their goods? How do they send their goods to the market? How many workers are provided with the means of livelihood? Means how many workers work in that factory? How are they given? Are they provided with all the facilities? Right? All these questions are also very important. And these questions you will ask to the factory owner, to the manager, to the workers. Which are the means of transport used to reach the factory? Means is that factory close to the transportation regions? Road, railways, airways. So that there can be easily convenient for raw materials and finished products. What provisions are made for the betterment of the workers? Means for the betterment of the workers means what? How, what facilities are provided to them? Right? Are the workers satisfied there? Do they have an actual working period there? Are they given enough salary? So all these things are very important. What precautions will be taken? For example, if there are natural hazards, emergency things, what precautions should be taken for that natural hazard? That is also important. Then, what precautions are taken in the factory to reduce environmental pollution? Means, if the factory, you know, each and every factory needs to prevent environment. And so, if the pollution increases, that factory, we can say that if the factory is producing a lot of pollution, it's really harmful to the people, to the workers. So you should also ask that what precautions are taken during natural hazards to save the environmental pollutions. Dear students, this is a sample report. On the left hand side, some questions are arranged, and on the right hand side, right, some points are written which are to be discussed. So this way you can prepare a report of your task, of your assignment, and this way you can complete your field report. This is a format of field report: the date, name of the project, where are you visiting, how many students are visiting, where are you visiting, and then the questions and answers, whatever information you collect from that place. These are some of the important links of this lesson which you can go through. Thank you, dear students.